We're going to talk about The Map of Heaven, brand new number one New York Times bestseller with Dr. Eben Alexander. Hello, Dr. Alexander.
Good to be with you.
It is a pleasure. Welcome back to New Bedford, Massachusetts. Many of us met you at the Unitarian Church in New Bedford a while back with your first book.
I thoroughly enjoyed that, and I'll be coming back up there sometime in the next few weeks, actually, as a guest of the Marian Institute. So I'm looking forward to that.
That is awesome. In the meanwhile, say hello to Casey Sylvia. And Casey and I are intrigued by your newest book. Let's start with your compelling title. We thought you were a doctor, not a cartologist.
Right. Well, this is really, Map of Heaven is very much about taking a broad view of human history and destiny, and really of our thinking over the last few thousand years.
And yes, go ahead, please.
Taking it to the next level of understanding.
So tell us more about this.
All right. Well, Map of Heaven really goes back to the writings of the ancient Greeks, looks at Plato and Aristotle, and looks at many very sage minds in all cultures, the East and the West, and includes the 400 years of ascendance of natural science, which has resulted in our conventional materialist worldview of the 20th and early 21st century. But explains why, at the very core of it all, this is around a 2,600-year-old debate, the mind-body debate, all about the very nature of existence and how do we get deeper into understanding that.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where the science is actually brings a lot to the table, but also is greatly awakened by realizing the fundamental role of consciousness, soul, or spirit at the core of all that exists. And, of course, the field of quantum mechanics has been screaming that at us for more than a century, trying to push on us the fact that consciousness is fundamental in the universe. You cannot begin to describe reality without having a far more robust understanding of what consciousness is. And that's very much what Map of Heaven mm-hmm. is about, is demonstrating that reality to all of us. And, you know, the thinking, the conventional neuroscientific thinking that I harbored, I should say I worshipped before my coma, had everything to do with thinking the brain creates consciousness, that we can only know things through the ken of our physical senses. We cannot intuitively know things outside of our here and now. I know now that that's false, that science, this is really all about the deep discussion of the very nature of consciousness itself. Given that consciousness is the only thing any one of us truly knows exists, is our own consciousness, it puts it in perspective. You know, the science, conventional science I worshipped, tried to pretend that consciousness was an illusion, didn't even exist, was just the physical workings of the atoms, molecules, and cells of the brain. But that is where I had it completely wrong. And that's where a lot of scientists who are deeply into this realize that the cutting edge of science is now moving into that consciousness is truly fundamental in the universe. And it's going to be the discovery of how that consciousness can impact all of the unfolding reality that will bring the true rewards to the world.
Interesting.
So it's this consciousness that even in science, it's allowing you to believe in this afterlife. So with you being a neuroscientist, like mixing that science and religion, do the two cohabitate in a way that it's okay to say, okay, we can have the best of both worlds?
I would say it's not only okay, but then in fact, pure materialist science is doomed. It's a dead end. It doesn't lead towards truth. The truth involves one that's much more what was revealed to us through the original discoveries around quantum mechanics and the fundamental role of consciousness in the universe. That is where the truth lies. And in fact, the more modern experiments in quantum mechanics will call you to question everything you ever thought you knew about past, present, future, the nature of time flow and causality. This is all about getting to a deeper understanding of that and realizing that consciousness, soul, spirit, and I would say all of our consciousness being connected and connected to the divine, it is all part of that oneness. And we lose a lot when we follow that modern kind of scientific, conventional scientific thinking of reductive materialism, you know, reducing it all down to the subatomic particles, and saying that if we understand the laws that govern those particles and then build up the physics, chemistry, biology, then we can understand all that there is. The problem with that conventional science is it has zero, and I mean literally zero, to offer up about the fundamental mechanism of consciousness.
We're talking to Eben Alexander, the author of The Map of Heaven, kind of the sequel to Proof of Heaven. Dr. Alexander, I just wanted to ask you one more question. In Proof of Heaven, you had mentioned a near-death experience. Do you want to kind of touch on that and kind of sum that up really quickly?
Yeah, very briefly. The reason Proof of Heaven not only took the world by storm, it's in 43 countries now, but also the scientific world by storm. I'm often asked to speak to medical and surgical groups, nursing groups about all this, is because my neocortex was so horribly damaged by this gram-negative bacterial meningitis. I was driven into coma so rapidly, it was such a severe case that there, you know, basically nobody ever survives such a case. You're either dead or starting to recover by day two. So there I was on day seven, you know, still on the ventilator, and that's when my doctors made the case that there was so little hope for survival, only 2% with 0% chance of recovery, that they recommended stopping the antibiotics. And the medical profession gets this. They read those medical details of my story, and they realize, oh my God, this guy was so deathly ill, there's no way he's come back to any kind of function.
Mm-hmm.
And yet, within 8 weeks, I was actually better than I had been before. That part is very hard to explain.
Let me ask you, in the minute that we have left here, when we look at humankind, Doctor, are we reawakening to who we really, really are and what our true destiny really is in your book?
That is exactly what Map of Heaven is all about, is where that is going. But in truth, the deepest answers lie within us all. And so the appendix of Map of Heaven is very much about how differential sounds can be used to enhance deep transcendental states to allow any seeker to go deeper and deeper and get to this knowing.
Now, what has writing Proof of Heaven taught you that you didn't know before?
Well, it's taught me everything. I mean, the eternity of our souls and the interconnectedness of our souls and the importance of love. I mean, love, unconditional love, has infinite power to heal at all levels, individual, soul, group, humanity, all life on earth and beyond. That unconditional love is not anything that there's no force on earth that can unseat that unconditional love. It has infinite power, and that's a big part of the lesson that is brought in by Map of Heaven.
Thank you so much, Dr. Alexander. Do you have a website for our listeners to look
at? Yes, they can go to ebenalexander, ebenalexander.com, or go to eternia, eternea.org, or ians, ians.org, to learn a lot more.
Thank you again so much. This is Eben Alexander, The Map of Heaven. Thank you again, Doctor.
And we'll see you when you come up here.
Great. Looking forward to it. Thanks a lot for having me.